Hi and welcome to Watch and Work. Watch and Work is ContiTech's series of service videos for automotive mechanics. My name is Stefan Meyer, and in each video I'll show you a different vehicle engine. Follow me. The videos are aimed at professional mechanics, not DIY car enthusiasts.
Moin.
Here we have a 2-liter common rail engine with an output of 110 kilowatts from a 2015 VW Jetta with the engine code CUUB. We've already seen this engine in another episode when we looked at how to change the timing belt for the camshaft drive. Today we're going to deal with the oil pump belt. To change it, we need the CT1218 timing belt, our VO8 toolbox and a large counter hold. You first have to remove the multi-V belt drive here, followed by the entire timing belt. You should consider whether it's worth replacing the timing belt at the same time, as you basically do all the work involved, then remove the oil sump and oil pump too. Let's start by taking off the belts. I've already demonstrated how to do all that in another video that you can refer to if you're unsure of anything. I've taken off the belts, so now we have to remove the flange and the oil pump. Please remember to drain the oil first. Then we unscrew the timing belt drive sprocket here, for which we need this counter hold. We have now exposed the oil pump belt. To remove the belt, we have to take out the oil pump. There are three fastening bolts that have to be unscrewed for this. These must be replaced with new bolts afterwards. You can't reuse the old bolts here. So I'm just going to remove the pump now. There are two things you must watch out for with the oil pump. Firstly, we have a small seal here at the top that must be replaced. And secondly, we have two adapter sleeves here. You should check whether the sleeves are actually there. If not, these need to be replaced too. Now we come to the replacement. Take the new belt and place it in position together with the oil pump. There's no tensioning device. All the tension is applied through the pump. When fastening the bolts, you must pay attention to the bolt heads, as there are two different types, Torx head bolts and hex head bolts. The Torx bolts are tightening to a torque of 12 Newton meters plus 180 degrees, while the hex bolts are tightened to 10 Newton meters plus 180 degrees. Next, the sealing flange is refitted. Here again, there are different variants, either with or without an adapter sleeve. I don't need the adapter sleeve for the engine here. Clean the sealing surfaces here and then apply the sealant. We have a set sequence to follow for tightening the bolts. We start on the outside with the positions 1 to 6. The bolts are tightened in a diagonal sequence, first by hand and then finally to 30 Newton meters, again in a diagonal sequence. We'll come to the bolts on the bottom when we reattach the oil sump. Before you can refit the oil sump, you must first give it a good clean. Only use approved sealants and adhesives here when reattaching it. When you fit the oil sump, the bolts have to be tightened in a specific sequence. So we have a bolt 1 at the top here, and then we go round in a full circle until we get back to the same point. The bolts are tightened in three stages in a diagonal sequence. We start by tightening to 5 Newton meters in the first stage. Stage 2 involves tightening the three larger bolts on the transmission side to 40 Newton meters. And in the third stage, all the bolts around the edge are tightened further to 30 Newton meters, again in a diagonal pattern. Now it's time to replace the drive sprocket and bolt so that we can refit the timing belt. When doing this, please note that the bolt needs to be replaced and the new bolt is tightened to a torque of 180 Newton meters plus 135 degrees. This 135 degrees of tightening can be done in two stages, with 90 degrees first and then 45 degrees. And now we come back to the timing belt, which you have to install again in accordance with the manufacturer's instructions. So we are almost done. Now you just have to finish reassembling the engine. Follow the manufacturer's specifications, particularly for the tightening torques. Remember, don't overdo the tightening. Place our part replacement sticker in the engine compartments where it's clearly visible so that the customer sees you have installed quality.